You have seen the hub. Now let's talk about the contact sensor. This sensor came a long way. It started out as a prototype on a perf board and slowly got improved, optimized, and made more efficient. And for the first time, following your requests, I am making it available on my shop. So what is it, and what's new to version 3? The wireless contact sensor is an ultra-low power ESP8266-based door and window sensor. It is capable of reporting the status of a door, for example, to an MQTT server in real time using a hub. This allows for an instant reaction, like turning on a light as soon as the door is open. A small battery can last for years and allows for tens of thousands of status updates on a single charge. So what's new to version 3? To start, it has a brand new built-in battery charging circuitry. The battery can be left in the sensor and be charged in place. A new LED is used to show the charging status. It stays on while charging and goes off when it's fully charged. This is made possible by this chip. A second change, also related to the battery, is the plug. I switched from using two pin headers to a proper battery plug, the PH2.0. This allows for a more secure connection to a LiPo battery. As a bonus, it's non-reversible, so in theory, it should provide reverse polarity protection, but I will come back to this point a little later. The third change was adding a USB-C port for power. I initially wanted to use a micro USB, but with the increased popularity of the USB-C, I went ahead with it, even though it has a bigger footprint. The fourth change was the introduction of a new programming header. A not very well known fact about these FTDI adapters is if you use the side pins, which include the DTR and RST pins, you can automate the process of putting the ESP in programming mode and flashing it without pressing any buttons. This simple PCB I made can be soldered to an FTDI adapter, eliminating manual wiring and making flashing the sensor simple. I also noticed that I don't really need to solder female headers. I simply put the pins in and slightly twist the PCB and I get good connection 90% of the time. This saved me a lot of soldering time. And since this is an incremental upgrade, I carried over the rest of the design elements from version 2, like the micro switch, the detachable battery, and the LDO. I'm happy to report with the added hardware, the battery life stayed the same. The new sensor still idles at a single digit microamp, and the trigger time still pretty fast. And now today's video sponsor, PCBWay. I have been using PCBWay for years, and they are my go-to manufacturer for all my prototypes. I've been averaging a week from the time I place an order to the time I have them in my hands. I'm very happy with the quality so far, and ordering PCBs have come a long way, especially for hobbyists. So I encourage you to give them a visit. I will put a link to their site down below. Now back to the sensor. If you are using my hub, or at least my hub code, then this sensor should work out of the box. However, I made a small modification I want to mention. I changed how the ESP Now messages are sent. I used to simply broadcast the packages, but now I'm using an emulated address. This has the extra benefits of using the built-in acknowledgements and retries in the ESP Now protocol while keeping the sensor auto-discoverable by the hub. I talked about this a bit more in my ESP Now video, if you want to check it out. Going back to the point I made earlier about the battery plug, the PH2.0, I was surprised when I started buying the batteries. I was under the impression that the whole point of creating a non-reversible port is to force the polarity, but to my surprise, I found the batteries themselves don't have wiring standards. There are batteries that have the red wire on the left and others on the right. So pay attention to the polarity of the battery before you plug it in. Luckily, the plug is easy to modify, so swapping the wires wasn't very difficult. This wraps up the new contact sensor and its new design elements. In a future video, I will dig a bit more into the sensor, introduce a minimalistic hub, and show how the sensor can even be used without a hub altogether. I have a small batch available on my shop if you want to get it. Revision A was manually assembled by hand, and Revision B was manufactured with minor changes. The hub is also back in stock. Because of you, I can keep making more videos, improve my projects, and have them available to everyone. Thank you for watching.